Hello and welcome to Videojug. Have you ever wondered what the sun is and where it came from? Our sun is a star just like all the other stars in the sky. It only seems bigger and brighter because it's so close to us. Our sun was born 5.5 billion years ago from a swirling mass of gases. As the gases grouped together, the gravity became greater, dragging more and more gases into it. The planets formed around this whirlpool. Eventually, the gases became so condensed, the heat and pressure became so great, that a nuclear reaction took place. Hydrogen gas, which is what makes up 70% of the sun, began turning into helium gas. This reaction caused the sun to ignite, and that is what we see today. The sun is not burning. It's this massive nuclear reaction that makes it hot and bright. It is using up 4 million tons of mass every second. But there's a lot more to the sun than meets the eye. The sun is so big, it makes up 99% of the material in our solar system. The visible yellow sun you see in the sky is only a part of what makes up the sun. If we could take a slice through the sun, we could see it is made up of many different layers. The central core is where the reaction of hydrogen into helium takes place. The temperature here is 15 million degrees centigrade. This heat and reaction takes a long time to make its way to the surface, by which time it has cooled to a mere 10,000 degrees Fahrenheit or 6,000 degrees centigrade. But the surface of the sun is not stable. There are constant changes taking place. The most noticeable are sunspots. These are slightly cooler areas of the sun, caused by electrical storms bursting up from the center and exploding on the surface. Sunspots have been known to come and go in an 11-year cycle. There are periods when there are no sunspots on the surface, to periods when the sun is freckled with masses of them. These sunspots burst onto the surface, causing giant flares known as solar prominences. Huge flares stretching out into space, being thousands of times bigger than the Earth. The sun has an atmosphere. It is known as the corona, and it is a million times less bright than the surface of the sun. It is only visible during total eclipse. Like the Earth, the sun rotates, but at different speeds across its surface. At the equator, it rotates once every 25 days, but at the poles, it takes about 36 days. The sun emits radiation particles that are known as solar wind. When this solar wind hits the Earth, it is drawn towards the magnetic north and south poles and reacts with the Earth's upper atmosphere and causes the aurora. Colored lights that flicker across the sky at the extreme north and south poles. They are almost constant at the north and south poles. Our sun is a middle-aged star. It is not particularly bright and it is far from being very big. There are other stars that dwarf our sun. So, what happens to a star at the end of its life? Some stars explode violently in a supernova. But this will not happen to the sun. Instead, in about 6 billion years, our sun will use up all of its hydrogen, then it will begin to swell. It will engulf the orbit of Mercury, Venus, and the Earth, completely swallowing them up. Then gravity will make it condense, and it will collapse upon itself. Its light will go out, and it will become a white dwarf, surrounded by a planetary nebula. There are many examples of planetary nebula throughout the universe. But don't worry, you've still got time to get a suntan. For more intriguing looks into the universe, check out our other videos here at Videojug.